Good day, friends. Today, as you know, AICT has uploaded a draft professional engineering bill for comments, and we have tried to make a small presentation from our side, from the EV group, to make it familiar to all the stakeholders. So, CEV group welcomes you for watching this video. Please do not forget to like, comment and subscribe our registered values club for getting all new professional updates. So this video will be basically apprise you of draft professional engineers bill, that what is proposed and how you can give your suggestions. All things will be discussed in a small presentation which will be given in this video. This meeting was held by AICT, and the purpose of the meeting was to review the draft professional engineering bill. So AICT was tasked by Ministry of Education to align the bill with the National Education Policy 2020. So the basic aim of the session was to collect comments and input from the stakeholders. So the following AICT officers were present there: Professor T.G. Sitaram, Chairman AICT; Dr. Amit Datta, Director P&AP Bureau; Dr. Naveen Arora, Assistant Director P&AP Bureau; Shri N.K. Pandari, Consultant P&AP Bureau. So what is the purpose of the bill? So what is the purpose of the engineer's bill as far as draft engineering bill is concerned? The purpose is to establish an Indian professional engineering council. So what this IPE, this engineering professional engineering council, will be called IPEC. So IPC will regulate the engineering practices, ensuring they are performed by qualified professional, and it will focus on sustainable development and the safety and welfare of the people. So the bill basically aims to maintain internationally recognized standards for engineering compliances and ethics. So how this IPEC will be established? So Constitution of Indian Professional Engineers Council, it will be a statutory body with a perpetual succession and common seat. The council will have the authority to acquire, hold and dispose of both movable and immovable property, and the council will also have the right to contract and will be able to sue or be sued in its name. So what is the mission of IPEC? So mission of IPEC is to ensure that engineering activities are conducted by qualified professionals and focus on sustainability, safety and welfare of the society, and to promote high standard of competence, ethics and commitment to the engineering profession, and licensing competent institutions to ensure adherence to the standards and public benefits. How this IPC will be governed? The governance structure of IC will be that the Board of Governors will oversee the functioning of the council. There will be a total 12 number of board members, and then Secretary of Higher Education, Chairman of General Education Council and immediate post chairman of IPC, EC will be ex officio members of this council. Then there will be nominated members, three engineering, non-civil, one director of IIT, one director of NIT, one president of professional associations, then one president of INAE, oblique IRC, oblique IEC, BIS, nominated by rotation, and three outstanding civil engineers and two outstanding non-civil engineers will be nominated by Ministry of Education. Then, how the chairman will be selected? The chairman selection will be, it will be selected by a selection committee. The such selection committee will be chaired by an individual of the cabinet secretary rank. The chairman must have 25 years of professional engineer's experience, and the tenure of the chairman will be 3 years. Then, board functioning and meetings. The board will ensure that independent functioning of the council. The board will meet at least 3 times a year. The notice for the meeting, at least 2 weeks notice in advance, will be given for the meeting. The quorum of the meeting will be 2/3 of the members, and the secretary general will handle the administrative work but will not be a member of the board. Then, term and rotation of the members. Chairman's term will be for 3 years. Of the 8 non-ex officio members, 4 will be replaced every 2 years. This rotation ensures a mix of continuity and fresh perspectives within the board. Next, initial membership of IPEC. So, the initial membership will be 27 members for the first 3 years. Then 16 members will be nominated by the board, and 11 members will come from licensed member organizations. Members will be appointed as per regulations defined by the bill. Then there will be a general education council which will look after the educational part of engineers. So what will be the role of a general education council? The chairman of general education council will also serve as the convener of the board. The GEC will play a critical role in the standard setting for education and professional practices in the engineering field. 3 additional outstanding engineers will be nominated by Ministry of Education to work alongside the GEC chairman. The responsibility of the IPEC. So, its responsibility will be to monitor and enforce standards for engineering competence and safety, and then license institutions that meet the required standard, then to ensure that engineering practices contribute to the public safety and sustainable development. The council will facilitate continuous professional development. Next step will be the feedback from the stakeholders will be reviewed and incorporated. The finalized will be presented to the Ministry of Education for further approval, and efforts will be made to ensure widespread adoption of professional engineers bill. So the draft professional engineers bill, it aims to professionalize engineering practices in India. It is designed to ensure that engineering practices uphold the highest standards of competence, ethics, and public safety, and stakeholders are encouraged to provide their inputs and feedbacks for further refinement. So, this the link for the details of draft professional engineers bill 2025 is attached in the description as well as in the first comment of the post. Please submit all your relevant comments well before the time limit as mentioned in the request letter of AICTE. So this is all as far as this video is concerned. Please go through the draft professional engineers bill and submit your comments well before the time limits. Thank you for watching. Please do not forget to like, comment and subscribe and our registered values club YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.